one thing you have to sort of get used to is like thriving in ambiguity. You know, we're solving problems that no one has ever really solved before. I also think it's one of the more fun parts of my job, and I think ultimately it lets you have a much better impact at the work you're doing.
My name is Raghu. I'm on the markets team, so that's order entry and data in for markets.
We're a pretty small team, and we have like a very big reach. You know, we trade all around the world, all around the clock. You have a lot of responsibility and, you know, a lot of ownership over the kind of work you're doing, which is really cool. On a markets team, your high-level problem is, how do we improve our order placement time? How do we like do this new kind of trading, and like how do we track its risk effectively? How do we get ourselves onboarded onto this new market? Or how do we like speed up the performance of our builds? How do we improve research clusters' performance? Like things of that nature. The biggest thing about being on a markets team is you're dealing with a lot of ambiguity, because you're the part of HRT that interfaces with the external world. There are markets all over the world. They all like have different protocols, different technology quirks that you have to sort of get into the guts of and figure out. So it's not enough to just sort of engineer our own systems. We have to have a deep understanding of the systems of the markets that we trade on. Combining those two understandings is a big part of what we do here. I would say 90 to 95% of the code I write is C++. And there is, you know, a small amount of Python. There's maybe some like scripting jobs. We're in the business of being fast and like trying to make decisions quickly. And it's impossible to write really performant software without having some understanding of the actual hardware and the machine that it's running on. That being said, I don't think you have to come in with some sort of like expert low-level knowledge. I found that, you know, people who have a little bit of a background in systems and are all just generally curious about it tend to do very well here. Being like a collaborative person is also, I think, very important. HRT is a very open environment. Everyone can see all the code. Everyone can talk to everyone else. There's no internal siloing. We have so many smart people here. I feel like I've solved a lot of problems, you know, at lunch. You know, you go in, you have a problem, you talk to your coworkers, and you leave with, you know, maybe a few more things to try. I'm a really big foodie. I love going to new restaurants, going to shows, going to museums. Like, that's one thing I like about living in New York. There's always something to do. I really like playing chess. I'll often play online, or like I'll try to go to tournaments when I have time. It kind of is, you know, problem solving or like thinking on your feet. And also, like, a lot of chess to me is like pattern recognition. You see like a position and you like know, okay, I've seen this similar position before. Like, I know what worked or what didn't work. And that is kind of true of the job. You know, you see, like, after you work on things for a while, you start seeing, okay, like, we're doing this in this way. This is like a good way to do things. Trying to all get better, trying to like improve our understanding. And I think that kind of collaborative spirit is definitely also here at HRT. I really like, my number one, I think, the people. I really like my manager, I really like my team, and I like the kinds of problems we work on. I also like that I have a pretty broad mandate to work on whatever I think is important or work on whatever I think is interesting. From like the idea of, oh, we could do X better, to let's work on this and fix this problem. Distance between those two things is very small, which is really cool.